Hello, super user. So today we're going to learn how to create percussion lists in Finale. So if you've ever worked with percussionists and specifically writing for percussion parts, you'll often know that they often have multiple parts on one staff. And so in the part, it's actually a really good idea to right here have a list of all the instruments that they need to pull out for rehearsals or performance. It just also helps ensure that they don't accidentally forget anything. So the way we're going to do it is actually quite simple, because you might think originally that you want to have a text expression go up here and say, I don't know, snare or bass drum or something like that. The problem is, then it's on every single part. So the solution's a lot more sustainable and simple, and something that you can just put in your document styles. So we're going to create an expression. So come over here to your expression tool, and on the very first measure, double click, and we're going to create a new text expression. And specifically, we're going to create a new category. That way we can add different expressions for different staffs in case you have multiple percussion parts. So I like to start out with technique text, go to edit categories, and we're going to duplicate this one. And I'm going to call this percussion list. And there we go. And now we just need to customize it to our liking. So I personally use Roboto Lite in my scores. Non-italics, 12-point font works good. Justification left, that's good. And then here is where we're really going to get the correct positioning and placement. So instead of left of all no heads, we want to do left bar line. That'll start at the expression from here instead of somewhere in the middle where we don't control as much. And additional horizontal offset, we want this to be a negative number for how far left we want to put it. In my specific case, it's negative 8.6 spaces. Your needs may vary depending on your own document style. And instead of above baseline or entry, we're going to say above staff reference line. That is above this very top line of the staff, not one of these baselines over here or above any notes. It's always going to be consistent on every single score. In my specific case, it is 14 spaces above that. And if you hit OK, we'll have the new category, create percussion list, and then you can here add whatever percussion instruments you may have in the part. So for instance, you may have snare drum, you may have bass drum, you may have cymbal. I personally like to use all caps, you don't need to do that. But you just list out all your percussion instruments. Hit OK, and then hit assign, and it shows up right here on the part, as you would expect. Except for this is not a percussion part. There we go, on the percussion part. Now we do this, assign it, and it shows up perfectly placed. And the best part is, it doesn't show up on any of the other parts. Now it does appear in the score. And so if you have a different file for your parts and your score, that's totally fine. But if you have it on the same file, you're going to have to either manually right-click, unlink in parts, right-click, uncheck show to hide it in the score, or you can use JDBU change to change all the percussion lists in every single part. And so we're going to come up here to JDBU change, JDBU plugins, and then JDBU change. And then under expressions, you can change the visibility for any category. We want to only change it for the percussion list category. We don't want showing current, we want hiding current because we're on the score. We want to hide it on the score and show it everywhere else. But you'll just hit apply, and then close out of the window, and it will be gone in the score parts. And so that is how you create percussion lists in Finale. If you found this video at all helpful, make sure to hit the like button so I know you want more content just like this. And each week I post new videos about how to use Finale to its fullest, so if you don't want to miss out on any of those videos, make sure to hit the subscribe button and ring the bell so you get notified as soon as a new video comes out.